So far, we have learned how to format our text inside the document. Now it's time to see how to format our basic page layout. To format the basic page layout in Writer, I can use the properties sidebar and use the page pane over here. If it's not open, you can click it and open. First of all, like in every text editing application, every document must have a defined paper size. I can define my paper size using this button over here. You see now, the default paper size is always the A4 standard ISO paper size. If you want to learn more about the A series paper size, this is a standard that most of the printers in the world are using. Basically, all the printers, they are using the A4 standard, and some more bigger printers, they might have the A3 paper support. So let's go back now to my document. So I can change my paper size to A3, which is bigger, and you see now my document fits in one page. I can make it again to the standard A4 paper size. And you see now my document has a second page. Most of the time you're going to use the A4 paper size because this is the paper size most printers supports. And next we have the orientation of our document. This is very easy to change. Let's click this button over here. Now I'm in the portrait orientation, which is the default. So let's make it to the landscape orientation. You see now all these changes affect my document as a whole, all the pages. Later in this course, you're going to learn how to apply page formatting on individual pages. Let's go back now to the portrait mode. Now let's define the margins of our page. The margins is the white space area on top, on the bottom, on the right, and on the left of my page. Margins are very important because they make my document look more readable. To change the margins, one very quick way is to use the button over here and choose the narrow margins. You see now my margins are much more smaller. Or use the normal like before, or use the white margins. And the mirrored is being used for book printing. Let's put it back to normal. And of course you can set manually change your margins here using the buttons over here, or you can use the rulers. You see now my horizontal ruler here and the vertical ruler here. If you don't see your vertical ruler, you can go to the view rulers and click the vertical ruler. So the margin is the gray area of the ruler. So if I drag this here with my mouse, I can increase my left and right margins, and the same increase or decrease the top or bottom margin. But be very careful to drag the margin, not to drag the slider, which is being used for the, let's make it more clear. The slider, it's for the paragraph formatting, paragraph indenting. It affects only the paragraph. When you're going to change the margin, use this area over here. Drag the gray area. But again, as we said with paper size, you should be very careful with your margins. You should normally not play around with your margins and leave them with the default values. Because if you mess with your margins, then, for example, if you have margins like this, as you see, your document becomes somehow difficult to read. And most important, the printer will not print this page or will complain because of the way printers work, they cannot print too close to the edge of the paper. And as we will see later, we have more options for page formatting by clicking this button over here and bringing the page style window. Okay.